weekend is the name that weekend. You know, sometimes we see many people in the church. And some of us have seen so many people that for years and years, I mean, you tend to see the person and you remember the person's name and suddenly you forget the person's name. So, but with the names on this tab, during the Kiss of Peace, as you shake hands, don't just say peace be with you, but make sure the person's name. Say Peter, peace be with you. Honey, peace be with you. Dickie Greg, peace be with you. Mary, peace be with you. It shows that we are one. So it's just very, very important in our lives. So mention people's name as you are here in the church. Today's homily, I titled it, Count Your Blessings. Count your blessings. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. And if we surprise you, what the Lord has done. Tomorrow I celebrate my 13th anniversary of being a priest, and I'm counting my blessings. I thank God for all His blessings, all His protection, all His provision in my life. I've always cherished priesthood. If you ask me, one of the things that give me joy, the fact that I'm a priest. And as I celebrate this anniversary, if you look on the front page of the bulletin, you will see this small boy standing by the Irish priest. That is me. That was my first communion. I was standing with my Irish priest, Father Petrie. And looking at this picture reminded me how I used to serve at Mass as a kid, just like these little boys. And each time after serving at Mass, I would go home and try to celebrate my own Mass privately. And as I've mentioned before, that in those years, I thought that it was only English that God could understand. And I tried to mimic the Irish priest by speaking English. So I would go to a grocery shop and take the round cookies and bring it home, and I will raise it up, and I will say, because I did not understand what the Irish priest was saying there. I will get Coca-Cola and pour the Coca-Cola in a certain cup, just special cup that I just reserved for that mock mass. And I would pour the Coca-Cola inside that cup, raise it up, picturing myself to be a priest, and I would say, or drink the Coca-Cola. I would say that one day I will be a priest. Well, in the seminary when I finished my high school, my brother obtained a form for me to go and read law in the secular university. I took the form to my rector, that was my principal. He was so angry when I brought the form to him, and he refused to sign the form. And he said, even if no one from your class will become a priest, you must become a priest. And that was the end of going to the secular university. And today, I am a priest. As I look at this picture, it reminds me of Father Kettrick. Father Kettrick, he ministered in an old county for more than 30 years in several churches. In one of the last masses of Father Kettrick, he celebrated mass for the seminarians. We were about 10 seminarians at that mass. And I was the president of the seminarians at that time. And Father Kettrick looked at all of us and said, "Seeing you reminds me that I have not wasted my time in a Bakaleki diocese, my diocese." And he said, "Wherever I stop, you continue." And I'm so happy that the life that lived in my diocese is still on today. The flag is still on. I thank God in my life for all your support, for all your assistance since I came to this parish. And as I celebrate my anniversary, I pray that the good Lord will bless you because you are a blessing in my life. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Let me ask you this question. If you have never had any problem in your life, raise up your hand. If you have never had any problem in your life, if you have never been disappointed in your life, raise up your hand. As our faces are different, so our pain, our crosses, our differences, our anxieties, our disappointments. There are moments in our lives, moments that we thought that things would have gone right, but it went the other way. Moments that we wanted to smile, and all of a sudden, we saw ourselves sighing. Moments we wanted our spouses to cheer us up, and they are the ones letting us down. Moments we thought we have reached the climax of our goal, and all of a sudden, everything shatters. You see yourself beginning again. You see yourself from the base again. How about the times you continue to make effort, and thinking that things will improve? And the more effort you make, the worse the situation becomes. And you are about to give up. What about those people that you thought loved you, your loved ones? And suddenly, they are the ones pulling you down. They are the ones punching you. They are the ones letting you down. They are the ones frustrating you. And you begin to ask questions. Why me? Why my family? Why not in my life? And you are about to give up. The message of today is a message of restoration. It's a message of peace. It's a message of healing. It's a message of coming back. Coming back to our God.
You know, sometimes things don't work the way we have planned in life. Maybe the stress you're in right now. Maybe your spouse has been sick for a while. Or your son or your daughter. And keeps on bothering you. You have tried your best. But the more you try, the worse it becomes. Maybe things are no longer working well in your family. It's no longer the wife that you married that you're seeing at home. It's no longer your husband that you cherish that you're seeing. Things suddenly just changed. And you're no longer happy. You might be happy when you go outside, go to your work, but once you come home, you are not happy. Something is wrong. Something. I would like you to do one thing. Picture all these problems, all this frustration, all this pain, all this distraction in your life. Put it together in your mental basket and present them to God. Present them to Jesus Christ, who says to you today, come to me, all you who are burdened, and I will give you rest. I will give you peace. I will restore joy in your life again. Each time we come to Mass, we look at the crucifix and Jesus Christ is spreading his hands. Hands of welcome, hands of protection, hands of healing. Remind us again and again that he will never abandon us. No matter how far we are. Never you allow the stress, the difficulties of today to overshadow the success, the blessings of tomorrow. Don't just focus on your past mistakes, past failures, past disappointments. If you focus on those things, you never move forward. Expect to overcome your obstacles. Expect favors at home. Expect favors at your working place. Quit focusing on what is wrong with you and focus on what is right with you. You may have some weaknesses, but focus on your strength. Don't allow the past disappointments to ruin your future. Remember, it is not what happens to us that affects us. It is our interpretation of what happens to us. No matter what is happening in your life, if you say to yourself, I will make it, then you will make it. But if you say, I'm done, then you will be done. And then when you think that your own problem is the worst problem, just after Mass today, just sit down with one or two or three parishioners, listen to their own stories, listen to their own pain, and you will cross yourself and say, thank you God for my own problem. Some of those things that are bothering you, you see that some people will be glad enough to take those problems. No. All I'm saying, for you to focus on your own blessings, on the favors of God, on the victories you won, on the accomplishments you bring on it. Don't just focus on the frustrations. Count your blessings.
name them one by one. It will really surprise you what a good Lord has done in my life.
I would like to conclude my homily with
the words of Dick Sheweson, which says, "Count your garden by the flowers, never by the leaves that fall. Count your days by golden hours. Don't remember clouds at all. Count your nights by stars, not shadows. Count your life by smiles, not tears." Billie Jean King said, "No matter how tough, no matter what kind of outside pressure, no matter how many bad breaks along the way, I must keep my side for the final goal. To win, win, win. Don't just count your frustration, your pain, your sorrow, your difficulties. Count your victories. Count your success. Count your accomplishments. Count your blessings." Oprah Winfrey said, "Thank God for what you have, and you will have more. If you concentrate on those things you do not have, you will never have more. Count your blessings today, and you will be happy forever. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Surprise you what the Lord has done. Amen."